Hey everybody, I'm here today with a driving lesson on using the gas and the brake pedal. In this video, I will be showing you how to use the gas and the brake pedal, and it's geared towards people that are learning to drive, beginner drivers. With that being said, let's get right into the video. I'm gonna take the camera and I'm gonna bring it down here to where the gas and the brake pedal are. Just as you can see, let's get a better angle, just like that. And as you can see on the right over here, this is the gas pedal. It is the taller pedal. And if you're in park and you press the gas pedal, you'll hear the engine revving, okay? Make sure that you're in park before you press that gas pedal because you don't want to move the car. All right. Now this pedal over here on the left is the brake pedal. Now as you can see, it's a little bit of a wider pedal, just as you can see right there. And it is the one that will slow the car down and bring the car to a stop. Now what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take my camera and I'm going to mount it right here on this window, and I'm just going to show you how to figure out how to use the gas and the brake pedal effectively. So first and foremost, when people are learning to drive, they have a tendency to just press down those pedals pretty hard and pretty aggressively, and that's why when they press the gas pedal, it'll throw them back, and when they press the brake pedal, it'll throw them forward. I'm going to show you an easy way to actually make sure that you're doing this smoothly, and then I'll talk about the safety factor and how safety takes priority over smoothness. All right, so let's put my seatbelt on. I'm going to put the car in drive, okay, and I'm going to release the emergency brake, release the parking brake. Now, first and foremost, you have to imagine that there is something fragile and delicate on both pedals. And when you press on the pedal, you're pressing on the pedal with that fragile object on top of it. And you don't want to break that fragile object. So you want to press gently, but still with an assertive amount of force, meaning you need to know how much pressure you need to use. And that will come with practice. The more that you practice, the better that you'll be at controlling that gas pedal and the brake pedal. Now here's the thing, you're going to ease into the pedals when you use them, both the gas pedal and the brake pedal. Ease into them, and then when you reach the desired acceleration or braking power that you need, that you want, you're going to stop at that point and just hold it there. So if I'm pressing the gas pedal, like I will be in just a moment, I'm going to be pressing it and easing into it, and then I'm going to stop and hold it there when I get the acceleration that I want. So I'm in drive. My foot is on the brake pedal. What I'm going to do is I'm going to press the gas pedal and I'm going to ease into it. And I'm just going to hold it when I have the acceleration that I want. Let's just make sure that I'm good to go. There's no traffic, no pedestrians. I'm good to go. So I've released the brake pedal. This is what I'm doing with my foot. I've released the brake pedal. And now I'm pressing the gas pedal and I'm now holding it there. So I've literally just pressed it down just a bit. I'm holding it there and the speed is continually increasing. 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. I'm going faster and faster, even though I'm holding the gas pedal in the same spot. And now I'm sort of stuck at about 37 kilometers an hour. So if I want to maintain the speed, I just hold the gas pedal there. If I want to slow down, I'm going to ease off the gas pedal a bit. And now that I'm approaching the stop sign, I'm going to press the brake pedal. So I've released the gas pedal and I'm hovering over the brake pedal. I'm starting to press it gently. I'm giving it a little bit more force. This is what I'm doing with my foot. A little bit more force, and now I'm holding it here. And I know that by holding it here, I'm going to come to a complete stop on time. Okay? I'm just going to get out of the way in this intersection right here. Now, it's important to just practice as much as possible, because the more that you practice, the better that you'll be at controlling those pedals. Once again, and I'll just tell you what I'm doing. I won't use my hand this time, especially because the lighting is pretty bad right now in the video. But what you want to do is you want to just press the gas pedal like I'm going to do right now, and I'm holding it here. I eased into it and I'm just holding it here because I know that that's the acceleration that I want. And with the brake pedal, you want to do the exact same thing. When the time comes, in just a moment or two to press the brake pedal, I'm going to release the gas pedal. Now I'm pressing the brake pedal, I'm easing into it, and I'm just holding it there. And I know that I'm going to stop on time with the desired braking power. Now there's a few things that I should say, okay? The more acceleration that you need, the more that you're going to have to press, the more aggressively that you're going to have to press the gas pedal. The more braking power that you need, the more aggressively you're going to have to press the brake pedal. If I need to accelerate to a higher speed in a shorter distance, I'm going to have to press the gas pedal much harder and much more aggressively. If I need to brake in a shorter distance, or I have less distance to brake, or I have to brake from a higher speed, that I need to press the brake pedal more aggressively. And that's what it comes down to. You need to figure out what braking distance or acceleration distance you have and the braking power or the acceleration power that you need. And you're gonna use those two in combination with each other to figure out how much you have to press the pedal. Obviously, the more acceleration that you need, the harder that you're gonna have to press the gas pedal. The more braking power that you need, the harder that you're gonna have to press the brake pedal. And that's basically it. The key is to practice. I cannot emphasize this enough. The more that you practice, the better prepared that you will be to actually press that gas pedal and brake pedal effectively. And when it comes to the driving test, if you are watching this and you're a beginner driver and you still have to take your driving test, it's very important for the driving examiner to feel that smoothness when you are pressing the gas pedal and the brake pedal. Now, there's one last thing that I have to say, and that is about safety. Safety takes priority over smoothness. So that means that although you want to ease into them and hold them at a certain spot, both pedals, for smoothness, if you have to press them aggressively for safety, then you have to do that. It's as simple as that. Let's say you want to brake smoothly, but the person in front of you slams on their brakes and you need to slam on your brakes too. Well, don't worry about braking smoothly, brake safely and slam on your brakes if you need to. If you need to press your accelerator pedal a little bit more harshly because, you know, for safety reasons, then do it. Don't worry about smoothness. Safety takes priority over smoothness, but the goal of telling you these things in this video is to make sure that you do it smoothly and safely. It's as simple as that. If you estimate properly and you don't have any surprises while you're driving, then you should be able to do it smoothly and safely. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.